Guys, before we get into a more serious topic, why not start off with some goodness? So Amber just posted this picture of herself on Instagram, something we've never seen before. But if you watch the music video where this came from, you'll understand why she doesn't. She directed it, it's really meaningful, and it blew me away. Okay, I'm sorry about that. Anyway, let's switch gears. If there is any silver lining to everything that's going on right now, it's that things like this can come to light and we can slowly but surely expose those who've done wrong and harmed others. Or we can at least try. And yesterday, it seems like an old fan cam of Jessica getting inappropriately touched came to light, and people claim to have identified the person who did it. But before we talk about it, if it turns out that Jessica doesn't want this going around, these tweets get removed by someone related to her party, let me know, give me a heads up, because if she doesn't want it going around, I will certainly remove this video. But not for this scumbag. And speaking of getting this removed, when this footage first came out, it seemed to have just disappeared immediately. Anyone who was a fan around that time can attest to the sudden disappearance of this footage and just everything around it. And if you haven't seen this yet, that's the reason why. It was weird, and now, with everything that's happening, it has finally resurfaced and is getting a lot of attention on Twitter. But hopefully, it reaches the right people. I can't play it here, but again, you can find it on Twitter. You basically see Girls' Generation standing there, waving to the kids in front of them, when suddenly, Jessica turns a bit, startled, whispers something to Hyoyeon, and Hyoyeon turns to the man right next to Jessica, looking furious. Luckily, Jessica got herself away from that man and the whole situation. Now, a big part of why this is blowing up again is that there is a claim that this man is actually KBS's vice president. Yeah. The same KBS that bans songs for inappropriate language or subject matters. So it brings back up the questions. Did SM help cover this up so they can maintain the relationship and still promote on the network? While this would explain how this disappeared all of a sudden, I haven't seen any confirmation that this is KBS's VP. But if it gets enough attention, I'm sure we'll find out. Hopefully. I hope whoever this is and whoever helped him cover this up, even if it's SM, goes down with the rest. Now, if you want some kind of positivity from this, some fans speculated that Jonghyun looks like he may have heard what was going on and went into full protective mode. Whether it's true or not, seeing how he treats the women around him, I don't have any doubt that he would have protected them as much as he could.